Citing a rise in crime, city officials in Rutland are holding a public forum tonight to discuss what they're doing about it.
Theft, car break-ins, and burglaries have gotten so bad that a group of citizens armed only with cell phone cameras are taking matters into their own hands.
Channel 3's Cam Smith joins us live from Rutland tonight, where he's been looking into this citizen patrol and what's behind it. Cam.
Yeah, Kat and Darren, the forum at the Paramount Theater is set to begin in just about a half hour. Now, the forum is the result of mounting frustration over what some residents see as the city's inability to keep them safe from crime. Now, one resident I spoke with says when she gets out of work at night, she patrols the city streets looking to deter criminals from stealing. A disturbing trend in Rutland, from car burglaries to attempted home break-ins, many captured on home surveillance systems. Haley Yurt grew up in Rutland and says the city has changed.
I can't imagine that feeling, constantly looking over your shoulder, but I feel like it shouldn't happen anymore.
In response to the current climate, she and more than 3,000 others from Rutland and the surrounding areas have joined a Facebook group called Stand Your Ground Vermont. They use the site to share videos and post warnings. Many group members also patrol the streets at night looking for suspicious behavior, sometimes confronting the criminals.
Bro, he says he's got a gun.
We like to try to keep an eye on the well-known people who are offenders and break into cars, try to get into homes. And it's sad that it's gotten that we have to patrol because there's not enough cops.
Rutland City Police Chief Brian Kilcullen says currently the department is down 3 officers. But a greater challenge are the systemic failures that put offenders immediately back on the streets to commit new crimes.
Those limitations really are set by statute. But they have a real impact, and typically it's been an adverse impact on public safety in the community.
The chief and mayor, Mike Dungis, worry that the actions of groups like Stand Your Ground could lead to people getting hurt. The mayor would rather engage these citizens in programs like Project Vision, which aims to connect drug users with available social services.
They really care to make a difference. And we want to take that care and that energy and focus it with the right training. So tie it to Project Vision and our leadership there, and have the community come together. They want to help. We're going to give you a path to help.
Now, the mayor says the forum will also touch on recruitment and retention of officers, as well as issues surrounding repeat offenders. Rutland County State's Attorney Ian Sullivan, as well as state leaders from the Agency of Human Services and the Department of Corrections, are expected to speak tonight. We'll have more for you coming up at 11. For now, live in Rutland, Cam Smith, Channel 3 News.